What's up, y'all? It's been a long time. I've kind of taken a break from YouTube, but I've been trying to get back into it. I know I said this a few weeks ago, but I'm gonna stick with it a little more. If it gets a little loud, please forgive me. I got bands above my gym who practice, and kind of one of the cool things about being on this location. But so let's get to it. My goal, my plan for a while has been to try to compete at the Arnold in March. I'm been really torn because, you know, I've been for a long time and wanting to really drop my body weight as well. But it's really hard to do both. So I have decided to put powerlifting on hold. You know, technically I've achieved what I set out to originally, and I hit my pro total. For me now, it's all about growing my business. And if I'm gonna do that, then I need to really look the part. You know, I've spent years studying and reading college textbooks and you know, course material from our friends who've gone to school for this particular shit, and I'm ready to kind of put it to use. You know, I really want to be successful in this. I'm really tired of my day job, and I want to showcase, you know, what I know and what I can do. And I feel like when you get stronger, it's always kind of cheapened. You know, people always are gonna come out and be like, oh, I could do that if I was that size. I could do that if I did steroids and blah, blah, blah. You know, people just always kind of assume, you know, shit about you. On the other hand, when you're, you know, built like me, I weighed in this morning at 386 pounds, which I didn't realize I had gained weight. I was like 370, 375 last time I weighed, and I feel like I didn't really move much, but for me, 10 to 15 pounds is sometimes a day thing, you know what I mean? So I could have accidentally walked in the kitchen and ate too much in the middle of the night and not even know it. You know, I probably would, because I have really bad sleep apnea. I can't sleep, I don't achieve REM according to my sleep study. I'm working on getting a CPAP for that to really help. I'm just exhausted all the time, and it's really kind of wearing me down. But I've made the announcement on Facebook that I will not compete again until, one, I can compete in a class without letters, meaning 308 or below, but my real target's 275, and that's, what, 111 pounds for me to lose. I, you know, I'm up for it. I don't give a fuck. I'm ready. I'm ending my fifth set programming after a week. I'm gonna be really focusing on cardio for probably the first 50 to 60 pounds. Today I came in, I did some cone work, a little bit of farmer's carry, light chest workout, and sprints. Did a little bit of jogging in the gym. I'm gonna post the sprints just because they look funny. You know, when I was in high school at like 250, I was, you know, one of the fastest guys in the school. I've never seen myself run before. I don't know if maybe I just feel fast and I'm really slow now, but it looks weird. I don't know how often I'm gonna film myself running, but I probably will, just because I don't really care about embarrassing myself. And It's not the most aesthetic thing in the world, but it's part of the journey, you know. I don't really give a fuck what people think about me. I think that's pretty well known. If you don't like me, I'll show you my dick anyways. You know, that's just who I am. That's what I do. These next few days are gonna be a little rough, going from contest prep calories to I need to lose 111 pounds as fast as possible calories. No special diet. This morning I had two protein shakes with banana and oatmeal, and that was it for my first two meals. And then I had chicken and broccoli for my first lunch. And oh, I had a random ass thing from Speedway, I don't know, because I was starving to death on my way over. I'm sure that was probably more than half my daily calories, but it still should put me a little under 2,500 calories for the day. I'm gonna have one more meal, try to put me at around 3,000. I know some people that might seem like a big number. For me, 3,000 calories is practically starvation mode. I apparently, according to my BMI, I burn around 3,700 calories laying in bed all day. So to work out, eat, work a stressful job on 3,000 calories is quite a bit, but I don't want to really go any lower. I'll lose weight faster, but you start damaging your metabolism, and you know, it's just not the way to go about it. You want to kind of ease yourself into it and let your body do its own thing, adjust and get used to it. And, you know, it's not a sprint, you know, despite what I did today. It's definitely a long distance journey, but I am going to try to speed it up some and get there as fast as I can, and start building a better physique. And I'm going to document all of it to show you guys it's possible. You know, I really just want to encourage people to live a better life, and I want to help people. So I guess I'll also announce on here, since I've done it everywhere else, I will be doing online coaching. I already coach people in person at my gym. I am going to be doing it online as well. Nutrition, workouts, recovery, you know, whole nine yards. So if you're looking for someone to take your programming and your diet out of your hands, you know, I'm definitely willing to be that person. My main focus is going to be for people who are like type 2 diabetics. I want to help people who really need it. You know, I mean, I wouldn't help anybody, you know, but for me, if I can take someone with an addiction, someone with a disease, and help them better themselves, that just mean a lot more to me than, you know, helping someone go from 12% body fat to 10, or, you know, a 225 bench to a 315 bench. You know, it's something I've always been kind of passionate about, is helping other people out. I've fucked myself over in the past, given way more of myself than I should. So my prices are going to be firm. I'm not going to do this for free. Obviously, I want to make a living out of it. If you really want to work hard and are willing to stay consistent, I will work with you. That being said, I'm not going to just take your money and have you do nothing. You know, some people have it like that. They can just pay. They say, hey, yeah, I have an online coach. And then they don't put in the work. They still eat like shit. And I'm not about that life. I don't want my name being dragged through the ground. If you come to me obese and you pay me, and a year from now you're still obese and you have seen no changes, I'm not going to let you keep paying me. I'm not going to let you say that this is, I'm your coach. If you're going to work with me, you're going to work hard. I am going to push you as you've never been pushed before. But I welcome all people to try it out. It's not going to be for everybody. But if you want to change your life and really see how the best version of you looks, then that's what I'm here for. All right, guys, I'm out of here. See you next time.